Hello students, welcome to NIRS Education Channel. Let us continue the lesson Weathering the Storm in Elsam. In our previous session, we came to know that Prashant and his friends, family members took shelter on the roof, and the next morning Prashant saw a horrifying scene that the water stretched as far as his eyes could see, and the swollen animal carcasses and human corpses floated in every direction. That was a horrifying scene, and Prashant was worried about his family, was thinking whether his family survived or not. About that he was continuously worrying. Now let us continue the lesson. 2 days later, which seemed to Prashant like 2 years, the rain ceased and rain waters slowly began to recede. Prashant was determined to seek out his family without further delay. But the situation was still dangerous, and his friend's family pleaded with Prashant to stay back a little while longer. But Prashant knew he had to go. See, 2 days later, which seemed Prashant like 2 years. 2 days seemed like 2 years for Prashant. Prashant was determined to seek out his family without further delay. On the third day, Prashant determined, took strong decision to seek out. Seek out means try to find out or to search. Okay. He decided to find out his family without further delay. But the situation was still dangerous. Yeah. Rain ceased and rain waters slowly began to recede. Recede means to move back or to retreat. It doesn't mean the situation came to normal condition. Still, there was a dangerous situation. And his friend's family pleaded with Prashant to stay back a little while longer. When he decided to go back to his village, his friend's family pleaded means begged or requested with Prashant to stay back a little while longer. But Prashant knew he had to go. Though they requested him, he was not ready to stay there. He decided to go back to his village. He equipped himself with a long study stick and then started on his 18 kilometers expedition back to his village through a swollen flood waters. It was a journey he would never forget. He prepared himself with a long sturdy stick. Sturdy means firm or strong stick. Okay. Then started his 18 kilometers expedition back to his village. He started his 18 kilometers expedition. Expedition means risky journey, or we can call it a journey undertaken by a group of people with particular purpose, especially that of exploration, research or war. So he took that risky journey expedition back to his village through the swollen flood water. Swollen means increased blood water. He had to move in that increased blood water. It was a journey he would never forget. That was journey that he would never forget. He constantly had to use his stick to locate the road to determine where the water was most shallow. And he continuously had to use his stick to locate the road, to identify the road and to determine where water was most shallow in order to decide where the water was most shallow. Shallow means not deep or of little depth. With the help of stick, he was identifying the road and he was identifying where there was shallow water. At places, it was waist deep and progress was slow. At several points, he lost the road and had to swim. At some places, it was waist deep. Water was there and progress was slow. He could not move fast. He moved slowly. At several points, he lost the road and had to swim. And in some places, he lost his road and he had to swim there. After some distance, he was relieved to find two friends of his uncle who were also returning to their village. After some distance, he saw friends of his uncle, two friends of his uncles. Then he felt relieved. Relieved means he got a kind of relief feeling. They decided to move ahead together. Move forward together. As they waded through the water, the scenes they witnessed grew more and more macabre. As they waded means walked or swimmed through the water, the scene they saw grew more and more macabre. Macabre means horrifying or disturbing or frightening. They had to push away many human bodies while they were moving forward. They had to push many human bodies, men, women, children, and carcasses of dogs, goats, and cattle that the current swept against them as they moved forward. As they were moving forward, because of the current or waves of the water, human bodies and animal carcasses, they were coming near them. Then they had to push them aside in order to move forward. Such a horrible scene. In every village that they passed, they could barely see a house standing. Okay, almost in every villages, houses had fallen. Okay, barely they could see a house standing. Very rarely they could see here and there one or two houses were standing. Prashant now wept out loud and long. He was sure that his family could not have survived this catastrophe. Then Prashant wept out loud and long. He cried. He expressed his sorrow. He was sure that his family could not have survived this catastrophe. He came to know that, or he was almost sure that his family could not have survived this catastrophe. His family probably washed away in this catastrophe. Catastrophe means disaster or calamity. He thought like that. Whether his family was really washed away or not. Let us see in the next session. Thank you for watching.